In the last video, we proved in a specific case that if we had a unit vector and then some other vector in the same space, we could create the projection of that vector V onto E, our unit vector, by simply scaling E by the dot product of V with E. Now we proved that in the very specific case that the angle between V and E is acute. There are actually five cases we could consider. The angle could be acute, the angle could be obtuse, and the angle could be 0, or pi over 2, or pi. So that's five different cases. It turns out this formula is valid in all five of those cases. Now, we didn't prove it. We only proved it in one case. It's entirely possible that I might ask you to prove one of the other cases on one of your quizzes this semester. Basically, you'd have a slightly different picture. So when I drew my picture, I drew an acute angle, and I used some right triangle trigonometry. If I've got that the angle between V and E is obtuse, then that angle won't show up in a right triangle. So I have a slightly different picture, but the result ends up being the same. I'm going to just state that and encourage you to study the proof of it in the case that we did and see if you can generalize that to see what would happen if you have an obtuse angle instead. And then also just verify that it works if your angle happens to be 0, or pi over 2, or pi, because all of those cases give you different pictures. All right, what I want to do now, though, is I want to say, let's let B just be a non-zero vector in N space. And V is still going to be just some vector in N space. And now I want to calculate P, which is going to be the projection of V onto B. But I'm getting rid of the restriction that the vector I'm projecting onto be a unit vector. So I'm going to have some vector B and some vector V. And I don't know whether it's parallel to B or making an acute angle or an obtuse angle. It actually doesn't matter. I'm going to draw a picture just for the sake of having a picture, but I'm never going to use the assumption that my angle between V and B is actually obtuse. If I did, I'd be breaking this up into cases. But I can find a formula for this if I know that this is valid for any unit vector. Because if I'm projecting onto B, in this case, this is what my projection would look like here. But when I project onto a vector, I'm projecting onto the line determined by that vector. And the line determined by B is exactly the same as the line determined by B hat, which would be B normalized. As long as B isn't the zero vector, I can stretch or shrink it to create a unit vector that points in the same direction. And projecting onto that unit vector will give me the same thing as projecting onto B, because if this is B, if this is longer than 1, B hat would be something that's a little bit shorter. If this is shorter than 1, B hat would be something that's a little bit longer, but it would determine the same line as what B does. So now I can say, oh, well, I can just use this formula with B hat in place of E. So I know that this is just going to be a multiple of B hat, and that's the scalar multiple is V dotted with B hat. But then I can actually work this out, because I know that B hat is just B normalized, scaled by the reciprocal of its magnitude. So let me clear some space and give myself a little bit more room here. That's going to equal, the scalar is V dotted with B scaled by the reciprocal of its magnitude, and I'm using this scalar to scale the vector B scaled by the reciprocal of its magnitude. So it's this scalar multiple of this vector. But I know I've got this nifty property of the dot product that if I'm scaling a vector, I can just take the dot product and then multiply by that scalar. So this thing in parentheses is the same as V dotted with B multiplied by the number 1 over the magnitude of B. And of course, this is just the scalar 1 over the magnitude of B times B. This is a scalar, this is a scalar, that's a scalar. I can combine all of those scalars, and I can say I'm just getting V dotted with B over the magnitude of B squared. That's all of these scalars combined, and I've got that many copies of B. All right, excellent. Now notice, if B was a unit vector, this is just going to be 1 in the denominator, and I get back the formula for projecting onto a unit vector. But this is a more general formula so that I can project onto any vector. And you'll sometimes see it written this way, V dotted with B over B dotted with itself, copies of B. Because, of course, the magnitude of B squared is just B dotted with itself. All right, so that gives me a formula for projecting onto an arbitrary vector. So, I can say that P is the vector projection of V onto B, and that's always going to be given by this formula, V dotted with B over, take your pick of how you want to write the denominator, copies of B. Obviously, B is not the zero vector. Remember, we did always specify that B had to be a non-zero vector because it has to be determining a direction. Okay. So that's what we're going to get. Now, I can also talk about what we call the scalar projection of V onto B. And what that is that's just the signed magnitude of the vector projection. If it was just the magnitude, it would always be positive. But I'm going to go with the signed magnitude. That way it's positive if the projection points in the same direction as B, and it's negative if the projection points in the opposite direction. And I can see from this formula that that scalar projection is just going to be V dotted with B over the magnitude of B. I want to be careful. It's not over the magnitude of B squared because I want to get the signed magnitude. So I'm going to say this, that's my B hat. That's the unit vector that points in the direction of B. This is what I'm scaling that unit vector by. So this is going to be the signed magnitude. So there's just one factor of the magnitude of B in the denominator. And this is denoted as comp. It's the component, it's the signed magnitude of the component that's parallel to B, comp V of B. Okay. So the vector projection is the vector that is parallel to B, and the scalar projection is just the signed magnitude of that vector. All right. In the next example, in the next video, we'll actually do an example where we're working with some numbers, because this has all been a little bit abstract.